Hello, receiving students, atheists, and teachers. Thank you. Take your seat. Receiving students and atheists, before we go on to our today's lesson, I would like to recap some few points that we have covered in our previous lesson, especially on rates. In our previous lesson, our first lesson on rate was to understand what really rate was and how it is applied in real life situation. So I would like to just recap some few points before we go into our today's lesson. Now, one of the things that you must know when we are talking about rate, we are comparing two different quantities. Unlike in ratio, from our previous lesson, we were comparing same quantities. So the difference between ratio and rate is that with ratio, you deal with same quantities, or you compare with same quantities. With rates, we are not dealing with same quantities, but it is opposite, which is different quantities. So that is the difference that you must know between rates and ratio. Another thing that you must know is that with rate, there is units given. Or rates have units, unlike ratios. Ratios, you don't indicate units, or they do not have units. Only rates which have units. So these are the two key points which I want you to understand in rates. And also, you can compare the difference between ratio and rates. Now, our today's lesson will be on comparing rates. So that's our today's lesson, receiving students and atheists, comparing rates. On the screen, I have a learning activity that I would like all of us to discuss the solution to this question here, example question, which is on the screen. Now, in discussing this solution to this problem here, we will also understand how we can compare rates. So, as we go through, it is important to understand what steps and process that is solved in comparing rates. So let us solve the problem to the question there, which is on the screen. Now the question is, a Toyota Hilux travels at the speed of 0.12 kilometer per hour. That is the rate. Now, what is the speed in meter per minute? If this vehicle, which is Toyota Hilux, if it travels at the speed of 0.1 kilometer per hour, what will be the speed in meter per minute? Now, receiving students and atheists, when we are comparing rates, it is important that both rates need to be exactly in the same unit. This is the key point that you must remember when comparing rates. Both rates must be in the same unit. So let us do this, let us solve this problem together. Now, can someone identify what two rates are we comparing from the example shown? Let us go back to the screen. From the question, what two rates are we comparing? Receiving students, you should give your answer. Let's have a hobby.
Kilometer an hour.
kilometer an hour, which is kilometer per hour. To what? This is another rate that we are trying to compare to what rate? What is the next rate that we are trying to compare? Yes?
Meter and minutes.
Meter per minutes. So we are trying to compare. Kilometer per hour to meter per minute. So this is what we are trying to compare. These are the two rates that we are trying to compare, which is kilometer per hour to meter per minute. Now, what figure is given? We have kilometer per hour, which is given. So it is 0.12. 0.12 kilometers per hour. How many it is in, or how is it in meter per minute? Now, when we are comparing, we are simply trying to change from this rate to this rate. Okay? Receiving students and ATs. When we are comparing, we are trying to change from one rate to another rate. Example, from this rate, which is kilometer per hour, to meter per minute. Now, how do we change, receiving students and ATs? How do we change from kilometer per hour to meter per minute? That is the next question that we must think about. And in this question, I would like to ask you, what is the first step is involved in here before we get to meter per minute? There are several steps that we must follow in order to change from kilometer per hour to meter per minute. So, can we brainstorm? What is the first step that we should do? Okay, let's have our friend on that far end there.
Multiply by 1,000.
Multiply by 1,000. So our friend says multiply by 1,000. Now, I would like your friends and I would like to know, why do we have to multiply by 1,000?
Because we want to change it to meters.
Very good. So you see, receiving students and ATs, first step is we have to change kilometers to meters. That's the process of converting kilometers from this rate to meter per minute, which is the next rate. And then we will then convert from here to minute, from hour to minute. So what our friend has said, she said that we multiply by 1,000. So in other words, we are trying to change kilometer to meter first. So 0.12 times 1,000. What is the distance in meters? 120 meters. Now, have we changed to meters per minute? Receiving students and ATs, have we changed to meters per minute? No, not yet. So, in this case, the rate is 120 meters per minute or per hour? It is still per hour. We have only changed kilometers to meters. We haven't changed our head. Now, this is the range. Before we get to our final answer, what is the next step? Yes?
Change the hour to minute.
Okay, we are going to change this 120 meters per hour to meters per minute. So we are going to change this hours to minute. How many minutes in 1 hour?
16.
So we know that there are 60 minutes in 1 hour. So what do we do? We multiply or we divide? Receiving students? We divide. So 120 divided by 60. And 60 over 60, which is minute. Now, what is the answer? Receiving students in 80s, please, can you solve the problem here? Can I have one answer, please? Can I have somebody giving me the answer? Okay, let's have Winnie. Okay, Winnie, can you give us the answer?
Two meters per minute.
Any answers? That's what your friend said. 2 meters per minute. Let's hear from Rachel. Rachel?
2 meters per minute.
2 meters per minute. Okay. What is the correct answer? Receiving students in 80s, the correct answer is 2 meters per minute. We have to say the correct, how we write it, we have to say it the way we write it. So, 2 meters per minute. Now, 0.12 kilometers per hour converted to meter per minute is 2 meters per minute. Receiving students in 80s, did you see how we converted from one rate to another? The steps are very important. Now, I have next example, which I will give it to you, and you will do it either in pairs or in your groups. Receiving students, if you are sitting down in pairs, you can do this practical example in pairs. Or if you are sitting down in groups, you can do it either in groups. Now, your practical learning activity is on the screen. The practical learning activity is a service station rate for petrol is 272 toea per liter. What is the rate in kina per liter? Now, identify what rate, from what rate to what rate are you comparing, or what two rates are you comparing. You go to identify that, and then you change. Or you convert.
Sit down and wait for one person to. Everybody has to contribute ideas. You guys okay? boys are doing their own work and girls are doing their own work. Come on, this is group discussion. What was the instruction? The instruction was to discuss the solution to the problem in group. So everybody has to contribute ideas in order to come up with the answer. Come on, boys. Join your girls and then discuss the answers with them. Work together with your group. Why are you multiplying by 1,000? Sorry? You are forgetting your kina. I'm Nito Yazin. Mankina. How many kinas? How many toyas in one kina? A kina means one kina. So how many toyas in one kina? Why you multiplying by 1,000? Why do you have to divide by 100? Why do you have to multiply by 1,000? Why multiply by 100? Why multiply by 1,100? I'm stuck. I'm here. Down there. No, what? Because this 120
from the top down.
That's from the top down. From the top down. Receiving students and ATs. Receiving students and ATs, let us start. Let us check our practical learning activity, or let us check the solution to the practical learning activity. Now,
What answers have you come up with? Receiving student, you can give your answers to your class teacher. For a moral class, let's have someone to give us the answer. Okay, let's have Eddie. Eddie, can you come up to the board or come up to the front and write your answer? And then maybe you can explain to your friends how you got your answer.
$272 per liter. Okay, 200. We all know that 100. One kina is equals to one kina is made up of 100 tears. So 200, 272 divided by 100. Is I move two decimal places to my left, to kina 72.
So Eddie, what is your rate? Eskina per liter. Okay. Now the rate here is tukina 72 toya per liter. Now, from this working out, Eddie has missed out some steps. It doesn't mean that he is wrong by doing that, but the steps that he missed out has been already calculated. He calculated, so he only gave the final answer. So what are the steps for the case of you others who cannot understand the working out of Eddie? We will try to fit in some of the steps that Eddie has missed out. So we know that we are trying to convert 272 toya per liter to kina per liter. So every one kina is made up of 100 toes. So that is what Eddie has done. Eddie has divided 272 toya by 100 kina. And then so the rate is 2 kina 72 toya per liter. 272 toya divided by 100 is 2 kina 72 toya. 100 divided by 100 is 1. So our answer is 2 kina 72 toya per liter. Now, if you can see the two examples here, the first one was totally different from the second one. Which example shows more steps or involves more steps and calculations that you need before you come to final answer? The first one. So you can see the first one is much more, which involves more steps than the second one. The first one, you have to convert. You are comparing quite a number of rates. The second one, you are comparing only from one to the next. Only not many rates are you comparing. So it is from toya to kina only. The second one, you are comparing kina to meter and then hours to minutes. That's why it involves many steps to get to the final answer. Now, receiving students and ATs, we will now move on to our activity, which is for this lesson. I would like you to take out your books and then do this activity individually. We have two learning activities which is on the screen or which will be given to you. Now, our first learning activity which is on the screen. A tap dripping water at 20 milliliter per hour will waste how many milliliter in a day? So that is the first learning activity. A tap dripping water at 20 milliliter per hour will waste how many milliliter in a day? Will waste in that. I will try to rephrase the question again. If you cannot understand it that way, okay, I'll put it the other way. The question simply means a tap dripping water at 20 milliliter per hour will waste. So, in other words, it means that in 1 hour, the tap waste about 20 milliliter. Okay? Now, how many milliliter will it waste in a day? That's the other way that you can understand that question. So if the tap drips at 20 milliliter per hour, which is being wasted, it's wasted water, or wasted water, which is running from the tap. If it is 20 milliliter per hour, how many milliliter will it be in per day, in a day? In a day, how many milliliter will it waste? So in other words, we are trying to compare 20 milliliter per hour to milliliter per day. So receiving students and ATs, I hope you have just understood the explanation. So if it is 20 milliliter per hour, how many water will be wasted in milliliter per day? receiving students in IT's. I hope you have copied the first question and you're working on that, working on the answer to the question. We will now move on to our next learning activity. Our next learning activity is Michael is paid at the rate of 1 kina per hour for working as a security guard. What is this in toya per day? In other words, what is the rate in toya per day? So in the second question, you are comparing 1 kina per hour to toya per day.
Do you have to change, Milenita? Why do you have to change? You are changing, converting hour to day only. So how many hours in one day? Oh, okay. So, shouldn't that's the key. And the first one.
Receiving students in IT's, I hope you have answered those two questions. Now, this is how we will answer the questions. The first question, we will correct it together. And then the next question, we will correct it in our next lesson. So let us correct the first question first. Can we have somebody to answer, give the answer to the first question? While receiving students, you can also give your answer to the first question. Receiving students, we will have Ella to give us the answer to the question. Class, we will have Ella to explain to the answer which is on the board.
A tap dripping water at 20 milliliter per hour will waste how many milliliter a day? One day, 24 hours is equals to 1 day, so 20 times 24 is equal to 480 milliliter per day.
Thank you. Let's give her two big claps. Now, receiving students and ATs, did you all have the same answer?
Yes.
Okay. You should have the same answer. Why she multiplied by 24? Because we know that in a day there are 24 hours. So, to find milliliter per day, she multiplied by 24. So the rate is 480 milliliter per day. Now, receiving students and ATs, our next question will be corrected in our next lesson. So to sum up the lesson for today, receiving students and ATs, to compare rates, both rates need to be exactly in the same units. In other words, when you are trying to compare rates, make sure the units are in the same units before you can change from one unit to another. Receiving students and ATs, this has brought us to the end of our lesson for today, and thank you very much for your participation. Thank you.